Hey guys, it's Jack and welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, we are going through my new planner for 2019 and 2020. If you missed it, in the beginning of May, I uploaded a video showing you a walkthrough of the new planners from Erin Condren. So this is without me setting it up and all that kind of stuff. So I am using a vertical neutral planner, as you can tell. And so in this video, I'm gonna show you guys how I set up everything and I'm super excited. So, whoops, my little sticker book. So the first thing I did was I went ahead and wrote my name here, which I actually don't like how it turned out. I've done better. This is a little sloppy, but whatever. I decided to just leave it. And then moving to the next page, this is the quotes, which I think are beautiful. And then here we have the year at a glance, and I love utilizing this to keep track of my periods, traveling, bills, and then paydays. So I didn't actually used to utilize this page until last year, and I loved how it worked out for me, so I'm gonna continue using this again. And I don't use the July 2020 to December 2020 because I'll already be in my next planner by then. So moving on, this page is the one I had the hardest time with, but after talking with Johnny, he actually gave me the idea, and then after he told me, you guys were chiming in and also suggested this, but I am using this as a monthly gratitude page. So for each month, I wrote in the month at the top and colored it in. I'll fill it up with all the things I'm grateful for that month. And I think this is gonna be a really awesome page. So I'm excited to use that. So now before each monthly page, there is this blank sheet of paper, and I am going to use this as my monthly budget. So I'll have a spending log, my starting amount that I have, and then all the bills I have due, and then all the income that I make that month. So that's where I'm going to keep track of all the money stuff. So before we get into the month, Erin Condren added these like goal setting pages. So I'm really excited. I had kind of a hard time figuring out what I wanted to do. So for example, this first page over here with all the dot grid, I actually wanted to make this a memory page, but then I saw somebody, I'll try to post their picture in here. I saw somebody do this habit tracker and I had to just like copy it because it was just so cute. And I love how this worked out. And I feel like it's way more like functional for me than just saving it for a monthly memory keeping. So I definitely like using that for the habit tracker instead. So for this side, this box was supposed to be for birthdays, but I put monthly favorites because I do monthly favorites videos. So every month I will fill that in with what my favorites are so I don't lose track. I'm gonna put my monthly goals right here. So I do like that box. This text box I'm just using for a verse of the month. So I used Matthew 5:16, which says, "In the same way, let your light shine before others that they may see your good deeds and glorify your Father in heaven." And then I drew a really ugly sun underneath. And then at this bottom part, it has dot grid. I'm actually going to use this for my memory keeping. I'm just going to put two little pictures there at the end of the month, and that will be my little space for memory keeping. So we'll try that out for the month of July and see how it goes. And if I like it, I'll keep it up with every month. But we'll test it out for this month. So I went ahead and planned my first month for July. So I decorated with some washi tape at the top and bottom, and then all the other stickers are all functional. So these event stickers that I have are my video uploads. If you guys like screenshot this, you'll see what videos I have planned for the whole month. But I also added my mom's birthday in here with little banner stickers, church, Bible study, what bills are due, and then like my meetings I have. And then I also wrote down my paydays. So this is a very like, it's very busy. Like the month itself is not busy, but it's like when you look at this, it's just very busy. And then the side column, I like to add like other things that I have planned for the month that I don't want to squeeze into the boxes, because as you can tell, they fill up very fast. So it's kind of my guide on what to add into the weekly pages, you know what I mean? And I didn't plan the week yet. I'll get to that later. But this side column helps me to figure out what I need to add for the weekly pages, if that makes sense. So that's what I'm using that for. So again, I'm using the vertical planner this year and I'm really excited. So again, I haven't decorated a weekly spread, so I'm excited to see what that's gonna be like, and of course I'll share it with you guys. So that's all I have for the front. So let's go through all the rest of the months and then go to the back where the note pages are. So this first note page, actually, I don't know what to do with. So if you guys have any ideas, go ahead and let me know. But all the rest I did set up. So I'm excited to share it with you guys. So this first page is actually going to be my cleaning schedule. So I really don't like how I wrote this, but I was totally inspired by another planner person. So I'm going to put their picture up on the screen so you guys can see. I just made mine colorful, but I have daily cleaning, weekly cleaning, bi-weekly cleaning, and then monthly cleaning. So this is just my cleaning schedule. Again, I wish I wrote the top a lot cuter, but you know what? It is what it is. I also don't like how I wrote this one on the next page. This is my meal ideas, and I actually made this with Johnny. He helped me come up with these ideas for breakfast, lunch, snacks, and dinner, because I've been doing the cooking for us, and a lot of times I don't know what that boy wants to eat. So I'll have this page to go back to so I know what I can make him that I know he'll enjoy. So that's why I sat down with him and I made him help me fill this out. So this will just be meal ideas if I am ever like in a rut or something and I don't know what to cook and I don't know what groceries to buy for the week. I'll just look at this for some ideas and inspiration. So the next page I'm super excited to fill out, but this is going to be my 6 month training to a half marathon. So you guys know in December I plan to run my very first half marathon and I'm so excited. I did use colors to kind of outline the little kaleidoscope crystals. I don't know, they look really cool, but I'm gonna fill this out because starting July 1st, I will have exactly 6 months to train for this half marathon. So I gotta like step up my training now. So I'm really, really excited and nervous for that. Next, I have a year in a pixel. So I had this in my like bullet journal, like separately from my life planner, and it's from January to December. But because I use the life planner from July to June, I really wanted to make everything else go from July to June also. So it's all like together and you know what I mean? It's all cohesive. So I did a new year in a pixels and I'm starting in July and I'll finish in June. So I'm excited for that. And then next we have the debt tracker. Ugh, the worst, but you know, you gotta stay on top of the finances. If not, you'll end up super in debt like me. And then next we have this coloring page, which I think maybe I will color in and use this as a memory keeping page. Maybe put like, you know, 3 or 4 Polaroid pictures in here at the end of the year. I'm not quite sure yet. If you guys have any other ideas, let me know. But I don't know what else to do with it. So I think I will color it in and use it to add some photos later. This next page, I was totally inspired by like everyone in the planner community. I will post a picture of like the first person that did this idea, but basically, this is a rewards page where it's kind of like you treat yourself to different things throughout the year. And as far as the stickers go, I actually used all of the hexagon stickers from the sticker booklet here. I'm just flip to the page and show you. So there were all these little hexagon stickers that I put on the darker hexagon spots on the page, and then I also use the hexagon stickers in the back. It was so funny, there's like exactly enough to cover all of the darker hexagons on this page, so that worked out perfectly. So on all the open hexagons, I just wrote down little like rewards, like a massage, a mani-pedi, or getting my nails done. Oh, mani-pedi and getting my nails done, that's the exact same thing. But like buying a new outfit, or going on vacation, things like that, like ways to treat myself. Once I actually do that thing, I'm gonna take one of these clear translucent hexagon stickers and place it on top. So I thought this would be fun. I don't really reward myself that much, to be honest, so this is a nice little reminder to treat myself, you know? So I'm excited to try this out. Otherwise, I didn't know what else to do with this page. I was just gonna rip it out. So I thought this might be fun to try out. And then the next page I have here, there's these 12 hexagons, and honestly, I really didn't know what to do with it. And I think it's cute, I love the hexagons, but I just don't know what to do with it. So what I'm planning to do, and I don't know how I'm gonna decorate it with stickers yet, but I'm just putting different places. I'm using this kind of as a checklist. Things I wanna do in San Diego. So I am very much like a homebody. I don't go out much. So I've lived in San Diego for so long, but there's actually a lot of places I've never been. So like different restaurants or different shops. So the places I want to go, I have added in here, and it's kind of just my little checklist. This page is the contacts page, and I actually just used a little bit of whiteout at the top and then some page flags to put gift ideas, and this is going to be gift ideas for mine and Johnny's family. So throughout the year, if I like think of an idea or think of something that I know someone will like, I'll add it here, and then when it's like a birthday or Christmas, we can refer back to this page for gift ideas. I think that would be cool. I saw a few other people doing this as well. Oh, and this next page, oh, I'm so excited. So I'm sure you guys have seen in my monthly hair update videos that I keep the strands of my hair in the back of my planner. I have a monthly hair growth tracker, but I decided to do a little DIY project and take out the hairs and transfer them to my new planner. And I love the setup. It works way better, and I'm able to organize the strands of hair. Johnny said this is so gross of me, but I like to visually see how fast my hair is growing. So I have the little sticker tabs at the top all the way to 12 months. Right now we're at 7 months. And I'm just going to continue adding my strands of hair here in the back until we get to month 12. And after the monthly hair growth tracker, we have the stickers in the back, which I actually use and I like. So I'm gonna rip these out because I just feel like I utilize my stickers more when they're not hidden in the back, you know, out of sight, out of mind. So I'm gonna rip the sticker pages out and put it into my sticker collection. And then the last thing in here is actually this little folder tab here, which is I really like. It's nice and thick, and you can keep, you know, whatever you want in there. But right now I have my perpetual calendar, and normally a perpetual calendar is meant to hold just birthdays and things like that. And it starts in January and ends in December. But again, I want everything to match my planner, so I wanted it to start in July and end in June. So again, with my handy dandy whiteout, I went ahead and customized this to go from July to June. So I used whiteout at the top, and I wrote in the months, and then I just used whiteout at the bottom and a matching pen to add in the dates so that they are the same, you know, like it matches with the months. And yeah, I really like how that turned out. And I actually use my perpetual calendar to mark down my workouts that I do. So I like seeing it this way because it shows me like how often I'm working out, or that I need to like pick it up and start working out a little bit more. So that's what I use. And that is basically everything in my planner. I'm so excited to start using it. It starts next week, so can't wait to share with you Plan With Me videos in my new planner. And yes, I actually am planning to do a full year flip through of my old planner, so that'll be up next week. And I did add a little charm. I got this from Go Wild, but I added that to the top, and I think it looks so cute. But I'm totally obsessed with my new planner, and I just can't wait to start it. So thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video and it gave you guys some ideas and inspiration in your own planner. And if you guys use the pages in any other way, please share in the description box. I'd love to hear your ideas and get some inspiration from you guys as well. So again, thank you guys for watching. I love you so much, and I'll see you next time. Bye.